So we've seen how to do these simple calculations just using these operators, plus, minus, multiply, divide, and power. But we can also use functions to do that. So in this section, I'm going to look at the use of functions, and we'll say something about fractions as well, because we haven't done that. Now, we're going to have a future lecture all about the types of data that we can use in Julia. But I want to show you just now, just a little sneak peek, type of, if I write that and I open and close parentheses and I just put in the value 3. What is the value 3? I'm going to hold down shift and hit the return or enter keys, and I see int64. It's a 64-bit integer. As I say, we're going to have a whole lecture, a lesson just about types. So it's a 64-bit integer. If I say 3.0, so I just went into that cell, just changed the line of code. I'm going to hold down shift, enter again. It will execute again. Now we see that's a 64-bit floating point value. But look at this. So we're going to look at all kinds of types in future. But let's do this. Type of plus. In Julia, phenomenally so, this plus operator is also a function. It can also perform a function. Now remember from mathematics, the f of x equals x squared. That's a function. F is a function of x. Same in computer programming languages. There's this function. And it takes certain values. The f of x takes the argument x. That x is called an argument in computer science, whereas it will just be called a variable in mathematics. Now, this is a function in its own right. So I can use it like this. I can say, as I would say the f of x, I'm going to say the plus of something. Now, just let me go back. See, once I open the parentheses, it automatically closes it for me, puts the cursor in between, a bit of text completion there in the Jupyter notebooks. It works really well. But I've got to give it some argument now. Now, arguments are separated by commas, and I want to add 2 plus 2, so I'm going to say 2 comma 2, not 2 plus 2. There's this function called plus, and I can actually just use a little plus sign instead of writing something like add or whatever. In Julia, it was coded that way, that you can use the actual mathematical sign as a function. So look at that. If I execute that line of code, indeed, it is going to be 4. Now I can also add some more, 4 and 7, oh, let's just carry on. I'm just hitting keys on my keyboard there. It'll do all of those for me. Now, you see it goes up there to 28. So it's just going to use all of these, and it's just going to pass these arguments to the add function, the plus function, and it takes what that function does, it just adds all the arguments. Let's look at minus. I can still say 3, 4, and again, I'm going to get my -1. No problem there. Multiplication, no problem there. 3 times 4 is 12. Division, I can also use division as a function. 12, 4, that's going to give me the 3.0. The power sign there, that's also 2, 4, that is 16. So no problem. I can use all these simple operators in Julia as functions, passing some arguments to a function. Now, just one more thing, the fractions. If I say 3 divided by 4, I'm going to get 0.7, but if I want to maintain that as a fraction, I can just use these double divide by signs. So I'm just putting in 2 forward slashes, and if I do that, it's going to maintain it as, instead of 0.75, it's going to maintain it as a fraction, 3/4. So much so that I can calculate the numerator of 3 divided by 4. The numerator is 3, and the keyword there is num. Keyword for the denominator is den, for denominator. 3/4, and that's going to return the 4. Julia's quite clever in that it will even simplify fractions for you. 6/9 can be simplified to 2/3. Indeed, no problem. Look at this, another line of markdown. So if I click in there, that was code. If I click in this code cell, this cell, it is actually markdown. Let's just double click on it to see how I constructed that. So you can see for markdown, I can use these little plus signs. As long as there's a space afterwards before the line starts, that'll be seen as a little bullet point. And here you can see what is called LaTeX. Now LaTeX, it's spelled like latex. So LaTeX code just executes code in a PDF in certain Office applications, if you have some add-ons, it'll render mathematical notation for you. So that's something you can learn how to do with time. And I hide them in between these little dollar signs, single dollar signs, that'll execute them in line. And even this value 1 here and this value 2, I'm rendering as LaTeX images. Look also at something else here. You see these little stars on either side of a word. That changes that text to italics. So you can just double click on that and you can very quickly learn something about LaTeX there and the use of some more markdown. That'll come with time. Beautiful bullet points there. I'm rendering fractions there. So that's not what I want you to see. I want you to see the fact that 5 divided by 3 is 1 and 2 thirds. So this 2 is the remainder. And indeed we can do that. What is the remainder of 5 divided by 3? So that REM is a function. I'm passing arguments to that. And it's going to work out the fact that that is indeed a 2. Now that is, I'm going to delete. Let's go to this line of code. I can get both that solution to the division and the remainder by using diff rem, and we're going to have let's do the 5 and 3 again, and you see 3 goes into 5 once with a remainder of 2. Excellent. You've learned all about functions now, how to use mathematical functions, and we've learned something about fractions as well and how to do divisions, calculating the division and the remainder. In the next section, we'll take a quick look at associations.